Jordan Henderson this week handed over his social media accounts to an anti-cyberbullying charity in another attempt to combat online hate. We obviously hope that has an impact, because we've also seen two of your players racially abused on social media, as has Rinsler Babajid of the women's team as well. So despite the action that's been taken over a number of months now, how do you feel that we are again addressing the issue of racism in the circumstances that we've seen?
What we are talking about now about racism or social media? So that's a problem. So with social media in general, we have obviously the problem that so far it didn't get sorted, that people can hide behind whatever account and say what they want to say. That's a problem, I think, we really, that has to get sorted on this planet as quick as possible. As much as each kind of racism should be stopped. And if somebody uses social media, I don't do that really. So and it's for me the thing is, and that's now maybe the not. I cannot speak like this about racism. I cannot speak about. I'm obviously not in a situation. I have no real idea about social media and the impact. To be 100% honest. But what I got criticized quite a lot in my life, how you can imagine, and not only recently, but probably as well. And what I learned and advice I could give people you don't know, people who are not interested in you really, people who don't want to help you with criticism, which can help sometimes, of course, don't listen. Don't listen. So it's always that you need, they need a forum for that. They need the situation that you take these kind of things for serious. That's how bullying works. That's how blaming works. That's how shouting works. That's how like criticism, too harsh criticism works. So if you cut that side off, then it's already a lot done and it cannot harm you. And that would be my advice to the players. And about all the rest, I don't understand enough about it, and I don't understand enough about the real need of social media. I know there are some good things for sure, but a lot of things are just not important. And I think if you can, for you as a person, if you can cut them off, then it's already a big step in the right direction.
On the pitch, Jürgen, is this a week of pressure, 3 points off the top four and a two-goal deficit to overturn against Madrid, or a week of opportunity?
Both. There's no opportunity without pressure. So because we're on the highest level of professional football, obviously. We want to fight for the Champions League, so qualifying for next year or being part of it still this year. So yes, it's an opportunity, but there's pressure as well, and we have to get ready for that 100%. And look, a week ago we spoke about a wonderful game we played against Arsenal, and it was a wonderful game. It was a great game of football. A few days later we played pretty much the opposite of a great game at Real Madrid, but this game shouldn't have any influence on the Aston Villa game tomorrow.
Is there an element as well of wanting to put things right after the league defeat at Villa Park, or was that done with victory in the FA Cup?
No. We played a different Aston Villa team, obviously, that night. No, it was not done, but it's not really helpful. But of course, we have to put things right. That's clear. But we had to put things right a few days after the Aston Villa game, a week after Aston Villa game, 3 weeks after Aston Villa game. Things like this should not happen. It happened to us. It was a really strange game, obviously. But yes, I have the game in my mind, and which way I will use it, I'm not sure yet. But yeah, we have to put things right for sure.
Thank you, Vinny. We've got Steve Wythe.
Jürgen, how much time do you spend reflecting on games? And was what happened at Villa Park one that you reflected on a little bit longer than usual, or was it one that you tried to put aside as quickly as possible?
You cannot put a game like this one aside immediately. That's not possible. And yes, we have a lot of games. I don't know if we played the few days after in the Champions League or not. I don't remember it anymore, to be 100% honest. But no. We had to work with it. A lot of things were showed us in that game, which were a problem that day, some of the problems we had before, some of the problems we never had before. And of course we work with it. And so that's the job, how you work with the results. The higher the stranger result is, that doesn't mean it gets more necessary to work with it. But in this case, for sure, we spoke about it and quite frequently. And the thing is, yeah, it differs how long it takes to me for getting over a game or getting focused on the next game. Usually, especially after a win, my mindset is immediately at the next game. But we still have to reflect on the last game. Not all of these informations go to the players, but I watch these games back and then I know better what happened really in a game. If you win it or lose it, there's no difference between that. I just try to understand why things happen. And yeah, unfortunately, I don't have these informations with the in the interviews I give after a game, which you obviously very often realize.
What have you made of Villa overall this season, not just from that game? They've made extraordinary progress. And bearing in mind they have a game in hand, do you see them as serious rivals across the final 8 or 9 games of the season for European football?
Of course they are. Of course they are. They are good. They are really good. Good setup. Made some good signings already long ago. Probably we will not see them anymore as signings, but I think Watkins was a, only to mention him, bringing Barkley in helped as well. All these kind of things. The rest of the team pretty much, not sure if the cash arrived this year, probably very good signing as well. And these kind of things. So yeah, really, really, really good side, and good sides in the Premier League are immediately in contention of for European spots. And yes, of course they are.
Thank you very much. We'll go to Carl Woodward from BBC Merseyside and then David Charlesworth from PA, and that concludes the Open as it stands. So, Carl from Merseyside.
Hi, Jürgen.
Hello.
We all know about how your results have been at home of late. We all know how important it is to start games well. So, is it even more important to start this game well in case, you know, if you do go a goal behind, you know, the mentality-wise of players, you know, their heads will go down? You know, how important is it to start a game well tomorrow?
Important. So you always want to start a game well. So you want to have a good start, but that doesn't happen all the time, but that doesn't mean anything. So you have to be ready if you don't get the momentum from the first second, you have to get it after 10 minutes or whatever, or the 5 minutes, or these kind of things. So yes, it's very important for sure. It's a while ago that we played a home game, and the results were not great. You are right. So we have to show a reaction, definitely.
Will it be hard for the players going into the game thinking about those results in the past, or they just go into the game with an open mind? It's a totally different game to what has gone past recently.
I don't think we are too much influenced by what you mean with the past, the last home games. They were all different and stuff like this. No, I don't think we will think about it. I will not think about it. So it's just the next opportunity for us, and it's a big one. It's a difficult one because the opponent is strong. And so we have to be ready to play a good game. So it's necessary that you can imagine playing a good game. If you can do that, then it's already a big step in the right direction. And that's what we tried yesterday, what we tried today. So it's again short break between the games, but it's long enough to be ready.
Okay. Any more, Carl? That's you done.
I was just going to ask another one about Naby Keita. How hard has it been since he's come to Liverpool? He's had quite a lot of injuries. Has it been frustrating for him as a player that he hasn't been able to show what he can do on the pitch on a more consistent basis?
Naby showed it. Not sure very often to full extent, but he showed it. He played important games for us, great games for us, scored important goals for us. That's all the truth. But you asked the question probably because of the early substitution in the last game, and it was just a decision I made in that moment. And we had to sort the game for us, and it was difficult to do that without making a change. And then after the game yesterday, we spoke, and it's everything is okay. I explained the decision, and he accepted it, obviously, and so now we carry on.
Okay, and David from Press Association, as the final in the open, if the guys for the embargo section will put their hands up, we'll come to you next. David first.
Hi there, Jürgen.
Hi.
Earlier in the press conference, just about Ollie Watkins, he obviously scored a hat-trick at Villa Park. That was a bit of his coming out party. It's his first season in the Premier League. I mean, he scored for England in recent days and against Fulham last week. I suppose you don't need any reminders about how dangerous he is, but how do you stop him? What are your plans for him?
First and foremost, in my memory, a lot of players scored a hat-trick that night. Felt like everybody scored a hat-trick, but yes, you're right. I think it was a very good moment for Aston Villa in general. I don't know exactly about the results before that, but after that, they were flying for a while. So that gave him a proper confidence boost. As a player, you need these kind of moments. And Ollie is a really talented striker. And obviously... the manager knew him from before, and it was a really good signing. Brentford? Where did he come from? Brentford, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
So the whole attacking line was exceptional in the championship season before, and so that suits really well. He's physically strong, so he can keep the ball. He can jump high. He's very fast. That's a good package. So nobody has to remind me on how good he is. But how we always try to defend strikers, we try to avoid passes into the area. And that's with him not different than it is to others.
And can I just ask about team news, who isn't available?
To be 100% honest, we don't know yet. We played on Tuesday, flew back on Wednesday, trained yesterday. Some players had still felt still the game, so injured is nobody no on from the game, but we have to see what we make with the information they give us today. So nobody's injured, but if we have to change something, you will see tomorrow.